Werewolf Lydia here, and welcome back to a new flea market haul on my channel. So it hasn't been a long since I did my last flea market haul, and I was really happy that I was able to go again at the flea market and 2 weeks in a row, and I did find a bunch of stuff. So I just wanted to show you guys all the things I got. They are pretty amazing figurines here. And before I start the video, I just wanted to mention, sorry about the bad lighting, it's that it's really, like, it's outside, it's like it's going to rain at any moment, but then again, sometimes the sun comes out and the light keeps changing, and I just didn't know what to do about it, so I'm really sorry if this video is in the best quality, but you will be able to see the stuff I get anyway, because, you know, I usually post a picture somewhere around here next to me, so you will be able to see the stuff there. I'm just going to explain the things I got as usual, so it's nothing really important to see. So you will be able to see the picture, so that I think that's okay, I hope so. So, yeah, the haul of 2 weeks, and I'm going to start the video now because it will be long, I think so. So, first and foremost, I have found a bunch and a bunch of Kinder figurines and other, well, not all of them are Kinder figurines, some of them are small, like, keychains and stuff like that, but now you will be able to see them on screen, and as I said before, there are a lot of them. I haven't counted how many pieces I found, and I did find some missing pieces, you know, missing little accessories and stuff like that, so I'm really happy about it. And now back to the video. So I don't know, I'm going to start off with the plushie, because that's the only plushie I have found. So, here it is, it's a cat fur. Here it is, it's a cute little skeleton monkey. You can see his tail. And it's from the Skelanimals, Skelanimals collection. And this is my first ever Skelanimal plushie. And he's really, really cute. Since I was, I don't know, a kid, I really wanted a Skelanimal like this, but they were pretty expensive and they weren't available in my country, in Romania, so at least I don't know of it. And I was just really happy to find one finally. By the way, I really, really like the their catchphrase, "Dead animals need love too." It's so cute. And yeah, so it was cheap and it's in awesome condition, like new, so, and I think it looks really good on my Living Dead Dolls shelf, you know, Living Dead Dolls, Living Dead Animals. So yeah, that was the plushie. Otherwise, all of them are figurines. Next up, I have finally found some more of the Bärenwald or Bear Family, whatever you want to call them, little flocked figurines. And these were kind of expensive where I got them, but they are animals that I didn't have before, so they are kind of, I guess, rare. And none of them had any clothes. I had some spare clothes that I gave them, but some of them are still naked. I'm sorry about that, by the way. Some of them are still naked because I didn't have time to actually sew some to make them some new dresses. So yes, sorry about that. So I found two little hedgehogs, and these are adult hedgehogs. So as you can see, one of them has I'm going to show you the clothes one first. So yes, I gave this one some clothes that I had, and the other clothes ones are this little panda, and this is the first panda in my collection. I think he's really cute. Oh, by the way, speaking of hedgehogs, I only had a little kid version, and that's why I was really happy to find two adults, because this way he can have a family, a whole family. So yeah, this little panda and this little squirrel, which I think it's, everything is full of cat fur. My cat has been sneaking around the stuff, I guess. But I didn't notice. So yeah, this little cute squirrel, which is again a first in my collection. I have never had a squirrel before. So yeah, these are the ones that have clothes now. And as I showed you before, another hedgehog. And yes, I have a bunch of bears, but these two little bear cubs were just so cute that I just couldn't leave them there. So yeah, I grabbed these as well with the other ones. And yeah, so that those are the Bear Freeman figures. Now moving on, I have found one of the another PCO, yes, it's PCO figurines. I have talked about PCO figurines and I started collecting them in the last Flea Market Haul video, so if you haven't seen it, that go ahead and watch it. And this time it's a Minion, and when I found this one, I had to choose if I want to collect every single PCO figurine that I find on the flea market, or if I just want to collect the figurines that are from movies that I actually liked. And I chose to collect every single PCO figurine because I'm a collector. And even though I don't like the Minions, I think they are super overrated. I just grabbed it. I think again the quality on this figurine is just really really good, and the paint job and everything. So yes, this is the only PCO figurine that I have found. Moving on, another Schleich figurine, which I was super happy about it. It's a little Pegasus. I think it's probably a little I don't know what's it called in English, the little horses, not a pony, the, you know, the horse cob. I have no idea what it's called, but it's a little one, and it's just so cute and so beautiful. It has some glitter on her, and it just looks really, really amazing. And it's a Schleich figurine. It was super cheap as well. So. And I collect, you know, mythological figurines and dragons, so it fits in my collection perfectly. The next one is a new Skylanders figurine. And this is my second one because I rarely find them for some odd reason. I only find the McDonald's versions and I'm not interested in those. I don't like the quality on them. But this one is an original one, and I have found one again on the flea market previously. But this one is I don't know much about Skylanders, so I had no idea. It was from 2012, and it has a fire symbol on it because, as you can see, it's a fire dog thing. And I think it's just really cute, and again, I love the quality of these figures. I don't play Skylanders, or I don't know anything about the game, but I like the figurines. And while they are cheap, why not grab them? The next figurines are kind of a mystery to me, because I absolutely have no idea what kind of figurines are there, and I'm asking you for your help, guys out there. If you recognize these figurines, please tell me down below in the comments what are these, because they are really really good quality. They are from that vinyl material, I think, and you can move their heads and stuff, but I have no idea what these are. So there is this, I found four of them and I really like them. I think they are really cute and good for decoration. So this little blue one is a ninja, and this purple one, he looks kind of crazy, like a, I don't know, like a jungle person or something, because he has a wine on him. The third one is this yellow girl, I guess, in a space suit or something. And the fourth one is this little devil guy. And I really really like them. I think they are really cool, and there's no writing on or anything on these figurines, so I have no idea what they are. They only have a little code or something, some numbers on the bottom of them, and they have these little metallic things on them. So I guess they were for some kind of game, you know, when the game can read their codes and I don't know. So I have no idea how to search for them on Google, so please, if you know anything about these, their names or the company that made them, please let me know down below in the comments so that I can get more info on these at least, so, or at least I know their names or something, because as I said before, they're really cool and I really like them, I just don't know anything about them. Okay, next up, actually these are some doll furniture, which I'm always happy to find because they are usually kind of expensive on the flea market, and they are I don't really have any doll furniture for pictures and such, so I'm always happy to find them. So one of them is actually a couch, and it's an original Monster High couch, so I was really surprised to find this, but I guess I shouldn't be because I have found a lot of Monster High dolls there previously, so whatever. But I have never found the Monster High furniture there before, but I guess I should keep looking. And yes, so this is a couch, and when I saw it, I immediately recognized because of the colors and the little skeletons and bones on here on the side. And I looked on the bottom of it and saw that it was made by Mattel, so I was sure that it's from Monster High, but I didn't recognize from what playset this was because I couldn't remember. And when I got home, I did a search and found out that this is from the Catacombs playset, so it's really cool, and you know, it's for Monster High dolls, so it's perfect. And the second little furniture is a bigger one, so I guess this was made for, I don't know, for some kind of other doll, and maybe it was handmade, I'm not sure, because it has a the structure of it is like this really hard some kind of metal, maybe iron, I'm not sure if it's iron, but something like that. And it was really, really old. It's a deck chair. I think it's called a deck chair. I'm not sure. And it has this... the seating is made of sponge. And it was covered with another fabric. And all of it was... The paint was chipped off. And it was really old looking. And you can see the picture right next to me how it looked. But since then, I needed it for a picture, for a calendar that I'm making with my OC dolls, and I needed the chair, it was perfect for the shot, and I have already, I don't know, restored it, or I repainted it, I covered the sponge part with a new fabric, and I think it looks really, really good, so I was really happy to find this, because it's a perfect size for Monster High dolls. And other similar size dolls as well. Another thing that I have found, again, Christmas in July, or Christmas in August, more likely, it's this little frog Christmas tree decoration. And again, I grabbed it because I had never seen a frog hanging on a Christmas tree. I think it's a frog prince, probably, because it looks like that he has some kind of crown on his head. And again, it's a really interesting and bizarre, and I don't know, it's just not something you would see on a Christmas tree. And you know, I like those kind of Christmas tree decorations. I always, whenever Christmas comes, I'm always on a search for a new and interesting, a new and interesting Christmas decoration. So yeah, I grabbed this one. Next up, some Pokemon figures, and I have actually found a lot of them. So, the first ones that I'm going to show you are from McDonald's. And this is Mega Latias or Latios, I'm not sure, I can never recognize which one is which. I still have to learn that. And he was supposed to come with something that shoots out of his mouth, because there's a hole in there and you can push this little transparent button thingy on the top of him, or her, and it was supposed to shoot out, but that's missing, but that's fine by me. The other two are from the recent, from the last year, McDonald's, and this is a Scratchy, I'm not sure that's the name, and you can just push him down like that and then he pops up, I guess. And the other one is Totodile, and he's really cute, and you have to push his back, these little spikes on his back, and he moves his mouth like he's biting or, I don't know, saying his name. So that's really cute. The other ones are smaller and a little bit different, made by different companies. So some of them are made by Tommy, which I really, really like because they are really good quality and look really good. So the first one is a Miss Rebus, and I'm not sure why she's green. I thought that she was more like I don't know, like an indigo color, but that's okay, I guess. So it's a Miss Rebus. Also from Tommy, there's a Raichu. I don't know, is this Tommy? Yes, an Articuno, the legendary bird. And I think those four were from Tommy. I'm not sure if this one is not from Tommy, it's just from Nintendo Pokemon. This is a Grotal, I'm not sure how to pronounce it. It's the second evolution of Turtwig. And there's also, just simply says Pokemon on it, so I'm not sure what the company that made it. It's a Fair Alligator. So with this one I have all the three evolutions of Totodile. You know, I showed you Totodile before. I have previously found Croconaw, and now I have Fair Alligator, so it's really cool. And last but not least, this tiny, teeny tiny Pokemon, and I have absolutely no idea how they made this or what company actually made this. And it's really, really well painted for how small it is. It's a little Mareep. And it's so cute. It's my tiniest Pokemon figure that I have in my collection. I wish I could find more, but I have no idea how this just wasn't lost in the oblivion, because it's so small. I don't, honestly, it's like made of similar material like Kinder figures, but I don't know if Kinder ever made some Pokemon figures. I have no idea, but it's really, really cute, so I have to be careful not to lose it, or my cat would snatch it or something. Okay, so those are the Pokemon figures. Now moving on, I have found one Littlest Pet Shop figure, and as I said before, I no longer collect Littlest Pet Shop figurines because I don't have the place to display them. But when I find some on the flea market, I grab them anyway because they are just really cheap and it's worth it. And this one is a little I don't know, some kind of tropical bird, and he's in kind of a bad shape. The previous owner has chewed on his head, on his beak, the tail, the legs, so it has all bite marks and such, and I was just so feeling so sorry for him because he's really cute, and no toy deserves to get a treatment like this. So yeah, he will be in a good place now with my other figurines. Next one is a little Yoo-hoo and Friends figurine, and I don't know, I think this is a little, again, cat fur, because it's fluffed, so the cat fur attaches to it. I'm not sure if this is a little fox, maybe? It looks like it, I guess. It's kind of dirty, you know, the flocked figures usually can get dirty really easy and you just can't get it off anymore. I tried to clean it as best I could, so I don't know if this is a little fox or something. I don't watch You and Friends or play the game, so I don't know a lot about the figures, but he's really cute, so he will go next to my other Yoo-hoo and Friends figurines. The next one is, and I only grabbed this one, hold on. So this is a Tasmanian Devil from Looney Tunes figurine, and he's in, the paint job has chipped at some parts on him, so I have to fix that. But I only grabbed this one because I don't collect Miraculous figures, although I like the cartoon. Because this one is a punker version of Taz, and he has a mohawk and leather boots and leather vest, and he just broke his electric guitar, you know, Taz. And I just only grabbed this one so that I can display it on my punker shelf, you know, where I store various punk related stuff. It's like a little shrine or I don't know, and I rarely find stuff that fits there, so I think that he will be a good addition. Although I do want to fix the where the paint has chipped off, and I do want to paint some details on the guitar and stuff like that. And I just noticed that it was made in 1994, so a long, long time ago, more than 20 years, with Warner Bros. And it was made on the Philippines, which is really interesting that it was not made in China. So, yeah, cool. Another two figurines are from TMNT, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, and from the 2012 version. This one is Leonardo, and this one is a foot soldier. And I wish the others were there, I would have grabbed them all. It was a little granny that was selling these, so I guess from his grandson. And yeah, but she didn't have the other ones. But I just couldn't leave them there. I mean, I'm really a fan of TMNT, and I collect stuff, so... And these were made by Viacom. And I don't know, to me, they look like parts of a board game, where, you know, these are the figurines that you have to move on the board game table thingy. So, I don't know, maybe they are from a board game, I have no idea, but they are really well painted and kind of good quality as well, so I'm going to display them with the other TMNT stuff that I have. And last but not least, I have these four little figures. They are some kind of, I guess I could call them monsters, or little warrior monster thingies. The thing is that they were made by Moose Toys, and I have no idea what these are. I haven't did a search on them yet, so I'm pretty sure I will be able to find them or what their names are. And I think they are made for maybe a game or a playset or something, because they are not, they don't have detailed paint job and stuff like that, so they are all just green and blue. Sorry. Green and blue, and two of them look like this swamp monster thingies, and the blue ones look like, I don't know, they're like they are made of rock or steel maybe, but they are kind of nice, and they were cheap as well, you know, they are just so small that I just grabbed them, and I will display them somewhere in my cabinet, maybe back there where I have my random figurines, probably. And yeah, I guess that's all, if I haven't forgotten anything, hopefully. So yeah, these are all the figures and stuff I found on the flea market in the last 2 weeks. I'm really satisfied. I haven't found this many stuff in a long, long time. And not to mention the Kinder figurines that I showed you on the at the start of the video, because there's a lot of them. So yes, I'm really, really satisfied, and I'm really happy. I have absolutely no idea what's my favorite. I just really like all of them, that's why I grabbed them, of course. And yeah, so next time when I will be able to go to the flea market, it's probably next Sunday, if it won't be raining or something like that, and hopefully I will be able to find more stuff, so then I will be able to update you guys and show you what I got there. And until then, leave a comment down below which one of these stuff is your favorite, and if you know anything about these little bobbleheads, or, well, it's not really a bobblehead, but it looks like a bubble, so you know what I mean. These little figures, please let me know in the comments down below, because I just really want to know what they are. And if you like my video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe if you want to see more flea market hauls or more doll and toy reviews and other random stuff. And I will stop blubbering now, so thank you so much for watching. Bye!